Hey guys, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Welcome to another programming lesson. In this series of videos, what we're going to try to do is program Flappy Birds in Visual Basic. So if you haven't played the game Flappy Birds before, feel free to Google it and have a go at it and then come back when you know what Flappy Birds is. So, in the first tutorial, what we're going to make sure that you can do is basically in Visual Basic, we're going to run a program where an object is falling down the screen at the beginning. So as soon as you run the program, an object appears on the screen and it's falling down at a certain gravity level. So if you're sure you can do that already, then feel free to skip this video. Otherwise, I will walk you guys through how to do that. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is open up Visual Basic. So let me just close down everything. So we're going to start from the beginning of Visual Basic. So you're going to open up Visual Basic, new projects. And you can give it a name, so I'm just gonna call it Flappy Bird. Okay, so you create the program, and at the beginning of the program you have a form, and in this form there's currently nothing right now. So if you run this program by clicking on Start Debugging, you can see that there is currently nothing in the form, okay? And you can type or click whatever you want, nothing's gonna happen. So let me just change the start position of the form to center screen, so it starts in the middle of my screen when I click start. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is create a picture box and put it in the middle of my window. Okay, and on the right hand side, I'm going to go to the properties panel and I'm going to change the color of my picture box to orange. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. And I'm also going to change the name of my picture box. So, go to the name property of picture box 1, and I'm gonna change it to bird. Okay, so this is my bird. I'm gonna make the window slightly bigger. Okay, so if I run this program now, still nothing happens, but you can see an orange box at the beginning. Okay, now I'm gonna let me drag one more object onto the screen, and this object that I'm dragging onto the screen is the timer object, which is located under components. So drag the timer object onto the screen, so I have timer here, and the timer interval, I'm going to make it 40 milliseconds. Okay, so if you double click in the form, you get to the coding section of the program. And when form one loads, what I want to do is I want to enable the timer. So I'm going to type timer1.enabled equals true. And this enables the timer at the beginning of my program. So if I double click on timer, whatever code that I type in here, it's going to be run automatically once every 40 milliseconds, which is what I typed in before. Okay, so what am I going to run in my program? Well, the first thing I'm going to do is declare some variables. So let's go back up to the top of the form of the coding section. Straight underneath public class form 1, I'm going to declare a variable called y speed, and basically it's the vertical speed, and I'm gonna make it 0. So dim y speed as integer equals 0. Okay, so this creates a y speed variable. It's gonna make it an integer, and it has the value of 0. And the next thing I'm gonna do is create a variable called gravity, and it's also an integer which holds a value of let's say 2. Okay, you'll see what these variables do in a second. So when timer 1 ticks, what I want to do is I want to increase the y speed by 1. Sorry, by the gravity value. Okay, so every time the timer ticks, y speed is going to increase by 2. So basically it's going to go from 0 to 2 to 4 to 6 and so on. And it's the speed of it is going to increase quite quickly. And then what I want to do is I want to change the position of the ball. So bird dot top is equal plus equal to y speed. Okay, so what this is going to do is it's going to increase the speed variable by the gravity. So it's going to go from 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. And the top position of the bird, which means the y position, it's going to increase by whatever the speed variable is. So initially, let's say the ball right now is in a position of 25. It has a y value of 25, so it's gonna originally increase by 0, then it's gonna increase by 2, and then it's gonna increase by 4, it's gonna increase by 6, and so on. So if we run the program now, we should see the bird falling down pretty quickly. Okay, and if you change the gravity value, it can either fall a bit slower, or if you want to make it fall a bit quicker, make it a bigger number and it'll fall a bit quicker. So now we have done the first part of the Flappy Birds tutorial in Visual Basic. See you guys next time.